Anti-maskers and anti-vaxxers aren't satisfied to just be those regular horrible things in our public health crisis. No, they gotta feel like bigger victims than that. And so you remember when Marjorie Greene implied that the thing about the stars and the Holocaust and all of that is so terrible and drew really negative reactions to her? Others watched that from out there across the country and liked it and wanted some of it for themselves. So take a look at this image. This is the owner of a hat store who had posed with the not vaccinated yellow star, which by the way is not new. There were protests in the UK a few months ago we were covering where they were wearing those. But that's what she did, and the reaction was not positive from the hat manufacturers, a powerful lobby if ever there is one. So you have the Stetson company saying, "We are aware of the situation in Nashville. We take this matter seriously and are investigating in order to take the necessary and appropriate next steps. Along with our distribution partners, Stetson condemns anti-Semitism and discrimination of any kind." And then finally, as a result of the offensive content and opinions shared by Hatworks in Nashville, Stetson and our distribution partners will cease the sale of all Stetson products. We thank you for your continued support and patience. They also lost the Gorin brothers, who said that they were horrified. And so the president saying it's making a mockery of the Holocaust, it's unacceptable. Now, the Hatworks proprietor said, "In no way did I intend to trivialize the Star of David or disrespect what happened to millions of people. My hope was to share my genuine concern and fear and to do all that I can to make sure that nothing like that ever happens again." Which the first sentence says we're not trying to trivialize it. The second one says, "No, I believe we're moving in that direction. It's the same." They just said it again. Like, yes, they would like me to protect my life and not give someone a deadly respiratory illness. And that is moving in the direction of the Holocaust, JR. When will this hat purveyor learn?
Well, she's been attacked by the mob is what else she said in one of those apologies. And can't believe that they're coming for me. I was just voicing my concerns of being afraid. I'm afraid to scared. And then therefore I have to now link it to the Holocaust because you're afraid and scared. What is that? What is the fear of this make you then cross over to making these Holocaust comparisons? Which by the way, after this BS apology, then she went on to still talk about on Memorial Day. Always remember, never forget. It's like the term that's usually said when you start talking about, when you remember what happened with the Holocaust and everything like that. Yeah. And she used that for Memorial Day to then talk about, make sure you still know your freedoms. And we know the background situation for what you're still trying to say. Still comparisons to the Holocaust, still comparisons about how important this is to make sure you burn your masks or else you're gonna be sent to the gas chambers. These same comparisons continue to happen. So we don't wanna hear any more of these apologies. We wanna hear more about how about a Kangol and Stetson are doing you wrong and now the mob is coming after you just like last summer. All that, all those images that you wanna scare your people with. Yeah, but we still know the main message you're pushing. You're another Marjorie Taylor Greene, and why reject her? Why reject her verbally if you're gonna do the same thing she's doing? Accept her. Call her your sister in anti-Semitism. Just do whatever you, at least be honest with who you are. Stop trying to hide it, at least, because the people who know who you are celebrating you for it.
Well, she was admitting who she was. And I think it's partly a case of overplaying your hand, man. Like there are people who you just have to, like they're too powerful. Like they can say stuff and get away with it. A hat store, it's easy to go to a different hat store, buy them somewhere else. You do not have the untouchable position in society that you might think that you do at your hat store. That's all I'm saying.
'Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.